Hi, this is Bhupinder. In this tutorial, I want to show you how you could maximize your Premium Pro space. So this is the default layout, and I want to make this layout so that it would occupy the maximum amount of space on my screen. Easiest thing to do is first to get rid of this task manager. So we right click on the task manager and we go to the task manager settings. In the task manager setting, just turn automatically hide the task bar in desktop mode on, and then we can just close that. So after closing the task manager, you can see that's gone, so we got a bit more space, and we don't really use this top bit. It's not really useful information here, so I want to get rid of this. What you can do is I bring an on-screen keyboard so it would be easier for you guys to see. So in order to get rid of this, you need to select Premium Pro obviously first, and then hold the Ctrl key and then press the backlash, and you can see now we got even more space. If you want to see your playback in full screen, what you can do is hold your Ctrl key and press this little guy here. And now you can see it on full screen. So if you press again, we come back to the normal layout. But if you hold the shift and press this thing, you could see some more options here. And then if you press that again, we are back to normal. Another thing I like to do always is to make that space smaller, make my timeline bigger because I spend more time in timeline. Also, I would like to increase my screen size. One important thing to note is that you're trying to maximize the playback screen. But if you keep pulling this to the left, it doesn't have much of an effect because the aspect ratio stays constant. If you want to increase it further, you need to bring this timeline lower to make it bigger. And after a certain level, moving this panel to the left makes no difference. So you have to move the panel to the right. You can see now when I move it a bit more, it becomes smaller. So you can see this is the maximized space. If I move it any further to the left, the playback space doesn't become bigger. So there is no sense of doing that. You have to adjust the timeline height against the effect controls width to maximize playback screen. Also, since now we have removed the top panel, we can't click on something to close the Premium Pro. What we got to do is to go click on the file and click on exit, or use the shortcut key Ctrl Q. So I press Ctrl Q and it closes. Also, I think very useful thing would be to get rid of this workplace selection. So in order to get rid of this, you could just click there to drag it out and close it. So we got rid of that. So if you want to access other programs, you can by bringing your mouse down. And if you want to bring back the setting that it was there originally, you could go to the window tab and then go to the workplaces, and then you could reset to saved layout, or you could save this layout as a new layout. You can give it a name. In this way you could toggle between different layouts for different purposes, and then you could just choose the type of layout you like to work with. Obviously, there are shortcut keys to toggle between, which you can come here to refer to. And here, there are various panels, windows, that you could turn off and on to increase the space according to the work that you're doing. Also, to get to the various tabs, you can always click here to get to the various tabs. Click here to get to various tabs. That's why I always make my playback screen bigger. I hope this video helps you to maximize the space of your screen, take full advantage of customization of Premium Pro. If it was useful, please don't forget to subscribe. I got lots of tutorial on Premiere Pro. You can find the link to the playlist in the description of this video. And I hope to see you in my next video. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.